Welcome to Satisfactory. I'm Dan. Our last episode, we started the steel factory. Wasn't quite finished. In the interim, I did a couple things. I expanded the walls of our factory a little bit. We added a storage container for quartz crystals and silica, for our personal use. And a bridge to connect our factory to our coal. And that's because, up this new ramp, we have our truck stations that we'll be bringing the coal into. Little door to go underground. And our truck stations will be up here. Now, I have a good question, though. This bridge, my nemesis when designing anything, because I'm never happy with bridges, I come up with a few underbelly designs for it. We have 4 stone pillar version. We have the 2 stone pillar version with metal beams. And just for some variety, I have the metal beams with painted little beams. I can go with any combination. Let me know in the comments what you like best. Today, however, we need to finish this factory. That involves finishing up our 620 pipes and 60 beams. We got a lot to do. We won't be getting to encased industrial beams today, but we're going to get this thing finished. We're going to get the roofs on. We're going to get it powered on. We're going to get lights, and we're going to get it running. Let's get started. So, a quick tutorial on the bridge. This is pretty simple. Right now, I just have these 2-meter foundations. I got 4 of them. They're painted to the basic concrete color. And I ran these concrete pillars from a 4-meter foundation wherever I set up these pillars. So I just ran it about the middle of the foundation. I tried several things, such as where I had 4 or 5 of them. And I ended up settling on just trying a couple different things. So you just run them across. And the beam ones, I just put down a couple of connectors and then ran the beam as long as I could, which is about 5 foundations. Is the maximum length is about 5 foundations. So the distance between the 2 different pillars is 10 foundations in the middle. It was pretty easy to do, pretty simple. I think it looks good. And on the outside, I just did the little lip like we did on the building, and I added the 1-meter foundations like we did on the building as well as kind of a little wall. I was gonna think about putting the fences up there, but I decided it's just better plain like this. And I had some, that's just road barriers in the middle dividing the road. So, and the pillar foundations obviously are just more concrete, more 4 meters with 2 under ramps, inverted ramps, pillar support. And I put 1 middle pillar, about 1 down. I just thought it looked good as a middle support. And then I didn't want to put the bottom pillar, so I used these concretes. I was looking at some photos of bridges, more simple bridges, because some of the complex bridges would have taken 40 hours to make. It would have been crazy. This just looks good. And once I tried it, it looks pretty good. All right, let's move on. Let's get this road done first. Let's finish up the trucks and get them started so we can have coal in here ready to go when we start, and we can get some power in here, turn these machines on, and get our steel ingots started so that we can just get started on the constructors upstairs. I need this many arrows, but it's done. I can always remove them later. Now I gotta go through and paint them. Let's see if we can add the barriers here. I'm not 100% sure we need them, but we're gonna do it anyways. Not everything's perfect, but you know, it's not bad. I'm satisfied. That is where it counts. I think the road is pretty well done. So now I think we need to get some coal over here and get these things powered up.
All right. So the first two belts are done. For the most part. We're right behind the truck stop. So what I did, I gotta still clean up all this mess. What I did is I took a bit of bus. I just set up a bus from there, basically doing the same thing, but I used the new four holes. Let me jump. So I used the glass on top of these foundations. Common, it's a common design for moving for a bus, just using the frame foundations and using a glass on it with maybe some railings. But instead of going outside of here, maybe on top, and we commonly go inside, but I really always hate the crossbars. So I use the new walls, and I just put it on the lower one. I put the walls that allowed me to easily have an entrance for the belts to go in without feeling like they're clipping through the little diagonal beams. And I just did that all the way, but it's looking pretty good. So I'm going to get that other belt, and then we're going to get those truck stations powered on. Okay, so here we are up top. You can see I just decided to stack them, and I think it works. So since we're just carrying it over here, I got to do it on the other side. I'm going to get these things run down, and then we're going to take a look. And done. Okay, so we have our four lines, probably three, coming in here. We'll be bringing in enough. We'll be bringing in about 780 plus a little bit extra for fuel. And we're just going to split a little bit off. It should only be using what it needs. So as long as we're bringing enough in for our factory over there and what we need for fuel, everything should work itself out kind of like a splitter manifold. So let me get everything powered and we're going to get the coal brought in. Okay, time to power it on and let's see if it works. Everything's coming. I've set all three miners that we're going to be using to use 270. So that should be more than enough than we need. It should be enough for the coal factory plus about 30 extra for fuel. We'll see how the actual fuel requirements are once we get the tractor moving back and forth, and then we can adjust to be more efficient. But for now, this will work just to give us a little buffer. Okay, coal's coming in nicely. Fuel line's full. We set up an extra one for fuel line in case I want to use fuel in both, but I'm just going to start with this. This one's empty because we're not including the fourth miner right now, but if we need to add more, we can. So it looks like this is working just fine. I think it's time we get back to our steel factory and get that finished up so we can get everything running. Let's go. Okay, time to get our steel production started. Our smelting room is in here. I've just playing around with signs and doors a little bit. I'll probably make adjustments. Up here is where we're going to get production going. Let's get this floor laid out and then we can get started. Okay, so here's our platform. This is what we're going to build on. It's our next floor. We got to put all those constructors down and then think about a way to route it. And actually, you know what would be really cool is if we could do what Kibitz does and just boop it. That would save us a lot of time. I don't think I have a boop button, do I? Let me go see. Do I have a boop button? Let me check. Okay. Here we go. Not sure if it'll work, but let's give it a shot. And bruh. We should go back to the bridge. All right, we're going to pretend that didn't happen. And while that didn't happen, I went ahead and made a sign that mapped out the project for our factory. We've completed some of it, like the steel ingots. Over here, we're going to make the beams and pipes. The beams don't have a lot of designated usage other than using for project assembly parts and our own personal use, so there's nothing really targeted for them. Like, we're not going to use screws or anything. So we might be able to convert some more to pipes later if we need it. For the pipes, we got a lot of plans for it. We're going to make them for encased industrial beams. We're going to be making for stators. Modular frames, which a lot of them are going to go to the heavy modular frames, but they need pipes too. And we're also going to use them for the rotors. The recipes were just so good. They reduce power usage. We're making a lot, and it just fit in. It actually is a little different from my original plan, but this is what we're going to use for. And this is all, again, for our personal Pioneer factory. We're going to have 30 left, which is for our personal use, and we probably will use a couple for maybe, like, making rifle ammo later.
We might add more, but we'll see. All right, I've gone ahead and added the pancake floor to cover up the mess from earlier that didn't happen. And up here, we're going to be putting all the constructors. It's a tight fit, but it's going to work. We have about, it's about 9 wide, which is what we need, because we're going to be putting rows of 7. We need 31 constructors. So we're going to be doing 4 rows of 7 constructors, and then the leftover row for pipes, which is our 5th row, and then we'll do a 6th row for beams, which is about 4 constructors. So we're going to get these laid down. We're going to put them on a single foundation, kind of like this, where the bars from the constructor in between, so that matches out perfectly. We're lined up. And with that, our floor holes that go with it, because I don't have any rods, because that was all planned. Okay, and the floor holes, we're going to be putting right up against, like, see the hole on the, if we're using concrete foundations, we're going to put it right up against that little square that's like meant for a floor hole. We can do that on both sides. Fits perfectly like that. So you can easily fit when you can tag it. Just like that. So this is how all of our constructors are going to look. So I'm going to go ahead. We're going to do rows of 7 for the first 4 rows. Just like this. We're going to repeat this 3 more times. We're going to put them right next to each other, like this. And then there'll be 2 more rows for the last bit of beams, and the last for pipes, and the one for beams. So let's add the rest of them. All right, now that we've got them all laid down, each one of the rows of 7 is going to produce 140 pipes. And so, like, for our encased industrial beams that we're talking about, where we need 280 pipes, the first 2 rows will produce as much as we need for that. And then, obviously, we'll be splitting up the second rows. But it doesn't really matter too much. The first 2 rows, obviously, we're going to go towards, we're going to be sending off to an encased industrial beam factory right here. And then the others, if we produce it here, we can direct it. But otherwise, we might actually produce them elsewhere. And we'll set up truck stations later, and we can perform the same kind of manifold trick with the rest of our pipes that we did with the coal, that we're doing with the coal right here. So it'll work out. Let's add the rest of the floor holes, and then we can move on to belt work for our ingots.
Okay, the top's all belted up. What I think we need to do is figure out how our belts are going to come from the truck stations up here. And that would allow us to decide how to belt up everything. Now, I'm pretty sure the coal's going to the layer below, and then the ingots from below are coming up. So I think we should figure out that, and then we'll know how to do the sandwich layer. But here is where we have our foundries. Our iron for the foundries is going to come from here. We did this in episode 6. We're going to move this so we can come here, and our iron's probably going to go in here. Yeah. So the coal's going to go in each one here. Coal's going to go here. And the iron's coming from the other side and is going to stop here. And the mergers are coming back this way. Since the coal is, we're going to set up the coal so it's going to be elevated. And then we can merger, our mergers for the actual ingots can go under it and go to wherever the spot is that we're going to bring it up to the next floor. All right, let's get the coal. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go get the iron rewired first, get that settled.
Thank you.
Okay. Iron's all mount, belted up. We are good to go on the iron. Now we just need to bring the coal down. Our coal is mapped up. I think it's... We have everything mapped up to get all the ingots started, so I think we should do that. So let me go get some power over to this building, and let's start wiring things up. Okay, so I'm starting the wiring, and I want to make a note. If we want to do lights, which I know we do, we want to know where we want to put the lights, because that can affect, if we're going to use ceiling mounts, whether you're going to use one and just to connect it to several buildings, or you're going to do one per building, you kind of want to know where you want these things, so you're not... You may not care about clipping, so, but if you do care, you might want to know where you're going to do your lights. In this case, I think I'm going to try to do right in the center of these rows, and we're going to turn it this way. So we now have a foundation and a half and a foundation and a half. That's good. Good even. So this is how I think we're going to do it. But let's now line it up this way and then see how that looks. All right. So I put a bunch of lights up, mostly centered on our rows, or at least on centered on the foundation of the rows. We don't have it on the edge. That's because we're doing it here. If we did it over the buildings, we could get it closer to each edge. But I think this will work. We could also not be even to the lines, and we could just do it, and it might be nice over here and mislined over here. So we're going to go with this, see how it looks. And I did this so that I know where I'm going to put all my wires to for my buildings, so they don't intersect this. And for our wiring, we're actually going to make sure that we don't cross the streams in a way. So we're going to bring our wiring for our buildings out to maybe this line, and we can connect it down this way. And our lights will go this way. And then we can bring that out to say here, further. And that way the next light can come out to here. Same thing on the line. Come out to the line, we can connect. And that way we're not crossing the lines for our lights. So if we wanted to have a separate circuit for our lights, coming from a light control panel, this way we can have two lines and they're not crossing each other. This light switch out. I'm gonna bring it out two. Ran out of wire or cable wire. And here we go for the next one. Okay, so I have wired up everything on the first floor for the smelting. So next to our little science here, I want to set up our sort of power infrastructure. I don't actually have power switches unlocked, I don't think. It is not available here. But I do have the light control panel done. So what I want to do is at least set up our light so we can bring power in, send the power out. We don't have our wall here yet. We will have one, but we are going to tap into this line, which is our main power line. What we're going to do is have the line come in and hit this one, and then this one's going to go out. This is going to control our lights, and it'll just go out to our power grid. It'll still work. If you wanted a separate light grid, you don't have to have them on the same wire network. That totally works. But since we're not having any double lighting or anything like that, this will work. So we're going to have it come in and maybe do right here. And then we'll have it go out into the next room right here. That way we can have a line come in, and we're also going to need to be able to send it up to the next floor. So that way we can actually take this one and move it past this thing, and it can go up. So we're going to have this one come in. We'll set up a wall one later. That'll come down to the light panel. The light panel will go up. If we have lights on, we got power. We don't have power. Oh, that's right. I need to hook it up. So we will just bring this one. Let's just do this here. And then we'll hook this here. Yay, we got power. And this should hook everything up. That's nice. Oh, so nice. We've got lighting. Gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. We could definitely have done many other things. We could put some, you know, wall-mounted lights if we wanted. But I think this will work. This gives us light. That's something to work for. Everything's got power now. So what we need to do is get the trucks running and get smelters going. And then we can start working on. This looks kind of cool. I really don't have a problem with this. I kind of like this. It's not the way we did any other styling for the building, but it's still pretty cool. Okay. We've got our power line here. We need to spruce that up and have it do something else. I think we can come in right. Just the way it's working. The way it's snapping. Fine, you know what? We're just going to come in right through the window. You don't want to give me fine control? We're just going to come right through the window. And then I need to take a window off to go through the side. Perfect. I wanted to see if we could put it across the beam. I don't know if we're going to do this, but you know what? If the wire's not hanging down below the beam, because I don't want to see the wire. I see the wire. Eh, it's not too bad. I don't know what we're gonna do for the roof. I'm gonna figure that out when we're done. When this thing's working, we'll tidy this all up and come to a conclusion. So we now have these working. We need to set them to unload. Now we're gonna wall this up. Fully know what we're gonna do there. All right. This needs to come down. So we're going to have this go right in here. Okay. All the iron ore is on its way. Let's go back up. The iron is moving. The manifolds haven't fully fired up, so we're not getting a full 270s here, but that's okay. By the time we get the truck set up, we should be pretty close to ready to go. So let's go get a truck set up. All right. I If I'm right, then this one tractor, which probably needs a little bit of fuel, should be enough to move all of the coal that we need. So we're going to give it a little fuel. And we're going to move it right in front of this station. Now we're going to start recording. One route should be enough. Let's see what happens. I don't think we need to worry about pausing anymore, because it seems like the pause gets set to 1 second, and it automatically adds pause nodes for any stations. We just need to actually make turns. And beautiful. All right. Let's do the turn. Let's not mess this up. Slow down. We'll do the turn. We pull into one station. I think it'll automatically mark the stops. I'm just going to kind of slow down and then I'm going to go. No, don't auto save. Let me get through the turn first. Ah. You ever get the feeling our autosaves are going to be ugly by the time we get to episode 20? And done. All right. The good news is, if we need to add another truck, we can just copy this path. But let's see what happens. Autopilot on. Here comes our little sugar cube. Kind of grinding the wall. I really am going to change this to more looking roads later. No! Oh, jeez. Did I get up yet? Oh, goodness. Make sure that our nodes do not do something stupid. And done. Oh, boy. Oh boy. See what happened there? It warped it as soon as I completed the loop. That's kind of annoying. But with any luck, that node over there is wide enough and it won't cause it to snag. So we're going to enable autopilot and go. You didn't take anything with you. It took lots of fuel. Fine, take it. Be free! Be free, my buddy! Be free, my sugar cube! And come back and do some work, you freaking lazy. Okay. While our coal truck is doing its thing, bringing us in the coal, making iron, we need to figure out where we're going to send the iron from below back up. Okay, so now I've got everything belted up and going up to the constructor floor. I decided to use some of the fancy frame pillars to encase the lifts. Looks kind of cool. I'm sure it'll look even better when it's running. It's already kind of filled up. So it goes up here. This one's coming out here because I kind of ran out of room because my walkway is the same level as the pancake floor. So I didn't quite have enough space. So I brought it back down here, the very last one for beams, and then ran it down in here, kind of hiding it from outside, and then back up where it needs to go. So it works. Just kind of adds to it. The last thing we need to do, well, we need to give the top floor a little bit more finishing touch so we can add power and ceiling and lights. And we need to kind of finish up decorating, and we need to add a roof here. We're going to try adding a roof and see if the new roofing tiles, if we can do a good job. And then we should be done. We've got everything else working. We just need to power this up. And then, of course, we need to send the pipes and beams off somewhere to do something. But that is a problem for another day. We're just going to get this working. So I was playing around and I kind of think I had the orange down in the walkway side, but this kind of looked cool to see the pancake floor. I kind of thought it was nice. So I think I want to do this, but we'll have to see what it looks like once I add more walls. But for some reason right now, I kind of like it. As you can kind of see in, it's a little reflective. The frame just adds a nuanced touch. It's cool. It works. I like it. But it might change. We'll see. So we need to add walls. We're gonna have to add some pillars. We got, because we got those pillars, and we got pillars from the bottom floor that are gonna need to come up as well. So we're gonna have to bring them up. Where are the pillars? I picked the wrong one. Oh, there's one right there. Don't miss. Go up like that. Now, someone recommended that I do the railing trick to get the half foundations, where I could do, stick one of these out, which is half a foundation, and then this will snap to it. And then I could have done this, where I'm not sure why I got down one, but basically I could have done this where I get half a frame. But I'm kind of committed at this point, so we're not going to do this. But it could definitely work. We'll just kind of continue our style. We'll see. I've been looking around ever since. Whenever I'm like driving around, you know, town, I see industrial buildings, and every once in a while I see something interesting. If I get a chance, I'll try to snap a picture of it, just so that I get an idea for Satisfactory. Usually it's the more blocky buildings, because building the crazy stuff is difficult. But I've seen a couple of good ideas when it comes to these flat top buildings. I saw one just the other day, like a day or two ago, where they literally had what looked like white beams building some sort of like little bit of architecture on top, like a empty cube. And I was like, that's interesting. So if they do it, we can do it, right? Somebody else, I think, had big like air conditioning system, you know, but they was like encased, but slightly elevated off the roof with a couple of like beam feet. So you could see kind of like just underneath it, but then you could tell it was kind of some industrial thing running inside of it. So that might work too. Maybe up here, you know, on this side, just for fun, I'm going to check. This is probably something we're not going to keep. But I'm going to try the other new window, this one. Just let's see what it looks like. You know, let's just glance at it. Oh, I thought I saw the edge of the building. All right, we're going to do that. Think we can get away with this? I don't think we're going to be able to get away with it. I think it's going to look. It's not horrible. I don't hate it. I don't think it works, though. Maybe we need to add a roof and see what happens. Is this three tall enough? I think so, right? All right, let me fill all this in. We need to jump out and take a look from below. Don't die. Only one bar. Take a look from a distance. Okay, we're not. A quick look doesn't look too bad. I think we need to get rid of that. It just sticks out like a sore thumb. Maybe I should keep these at the same as this floor. It's starting to look like a checkerboard. Not really my intention. Do something different. I can always do double window here. We would do it, or we just do the different window up top. We just do the clear ones. Maybe it'll. Oh, we haven't really done the whole thing yet. We haven't put these on. Can we do that from down here? Yes, we can. Come on, zoop it. Total ADHD moment right here. I need to get a roof for my constructors. Oh, hey, let's go downstairs and stylize the whole thing. That's what we want. That's what the audience wants. I feel like Snut said something that you don't have to do what I'm doing right now. You can do something to change it. Is it like control? It's control. That's right. Hold control and it lets you change the material. Why is it building in orange though? I mean, not any worse. Okay, I've got everything wired up for the top floor. I obviously added the ceiling, I added the lights, I added wiring for everything, put a few walls up. I haven't done the back yet. Everything's wired up for incoming. Mergers aren't done yet, but we'll talk about that in a minute. I ran a wire up through the floor here, through the wall outside, and then I put a power pole here. This was kind of in the way, so I wasn't sure, other than doing a roundabout up here, wasn't quite sure how to get a wire up, so I kind of jankingly put a power pole here to hide the wire coming up. So all we have to do is plug it in and our things will power on. And there we go. Power, and it's on. We have lights. They're gorgeous. And everything is still controlled by the light switch panel below. I think these arrows are too much. All I got to do now is we have to do the mergers down here. We have to decide where this is going to go. What we're going to do is actually going to set up another truck station over here. I think we'll do it over here. And we'll also have to have one for beams as well. But we'll set up truck stations maybe over here. This would be pretty good. And we can set a road off. And then we're going to have a new center hub that we're going to make. This one's our hub now, but we're going to have to take a new center hub, and we'll build stators there, we'll build the motors there, we'll build all our stuff, and we can have a new containers and everything piped down to it. So that's what we're going to do. We won't get to that today, but that's how we're going to get everything else out of here. So we're just going to easily combine as many of this can and send them off to truck stations, and these two will go back here and do encased industrial beams. I'm not sure we'll get to that today. That's okay. It's just a lot to do. So, what I need to do, though, is finish decorating these walls. And so, let me finish decorating the walls, and I'm going to get the mergers put together, and then we'll take a look at it, what it looks like at the end. I'm going to fix this wall, too. Okay, so everything's just about finished up. Here's our cold drop-off point. I added lights along the entire highway, which look really good at night. If I get a night shot, I will. We've added a roof to our logistics place. I put some beams and used you can't attach the light to the beams directly. So I used the flat frame foundation and used that to attach the light. So I just stuck the frame foundation in the beam. I used the wall. I just got the, I just connected the middle and removed the other ones. That way I can attach the light to it. So we have some light in here. We have our functioning factory up here. Or this is the pancake floor entrance, and this is our factory floor entrance. We have some nice new back walls back here. I added this little mid wall over here for fun. I might add it here, I hadn't really decided, but I added this little mid wall here, and I have pillars, which you'll see in a moment. Little decorations just for fun along the back. There's roof access up here, so you can climb up here to the roof if you want. I've got some little windows up here. And so this is the roof side, flat over there. And the roof axis, little sign, roof. That was not there. I'll fix that later. So we go up here on the roof. I have a little tower for just for viewing this. I added this really, really dumb, terrible looking air conditioning system. There was a guy that posted one on Reddit, and the Snoot and Jay showed it off in a community event. I made a terrible, I did not copy it directly. I kind of used the idea. And I modified a little bit, just made this one here, and I wasn't really sure I was going to make a good looking one, so I just left the one, and then I just left my fake dumb square over here, and I added a bunch of just fun little pipes just for fun, just give the top a little life. Doesn't do anything, just looks kind of cool. And then on the outside, if I can jump down without killing myself, yay! Ow. And on the back, I did fill it in. I used a little bit of decoration. I just added a few angles with the, you know, the little ramp walls. I added a few angles. I mimicked our window from over here, right here, except for here I was using the stone foundations, concrete ones, with a little color. Just add some color to the back. It's not going to get viewed very much, so I wasn't too worried about it. Underneath, I have added just pillars just to provide some support, just for the look of it. Finished off this area, added some more lights down here for no good reason, except to see through that window. It's kind of open here, but they're just miners.
On this side, I did pillars all the way up like the front. I left this walkway kind of open. Again, some angles for fun. Just playing around with it. Same over here, pillars all the way up. I gave the color from here. I just carried it on. Just thought it looked good. Same here, kind of put the color there. I tried some other things like running vertical pillars, but it had some weird clipping issues that I didn't like. Over here for this little extension thing, I put a stairway. Because, you know, we love stairways in this playthrough. They're just Final Fantasy stuff. So I just was over here going, you know, I need a way up and down the levels from over here because I was over here a lot. So I just figured this stairway was a nice way to get up. I have a little door over here, of course, for... Was that fog? I don't... Oh, cool. So just pancake floor entrance, administrative stuff. Put some stairways here just to get up here and down. That way I didn't have this floor running all up at the same pancake floor all the way around. So that works. We have our lighting in there. Everything's running. I did add more lighting on the outside on the second floor. I have some walls to fill up here apparently. So I started going through and running these. I thought it looked pretty good. When you set the gamma to 1, because right now I'm running gamma 2, but at nighttime you set the gamma 1, it gets dark. So it's a great way. If you want to test your lighting system, set your gamma to 1 at nighttime and you're going to see where you need lighting. That said, we ran into a slight issue, or not really an issue, but a little problem. And that is with all the lighting and factory running, we now have a max consumption over our 1800 megawatts. So our coal factory is already being used up. Obviously, we're only actually using about half of that. And the funny thing is these lights use surprisingly a lot. Is not on standby? Let's see. Now they took it off. Yeah. So lights are fun. They don't always work perfectly. You can see it dropped. The actual consumption dropped by about 200 megawatts with all the current lights being used. So I kind of didn't add these to the third floor. I'll come back and add them later. So that's basically it, what we're going to do for today. I am actually going to add some sinks, some awesome sinks over here just for testing purposes. I'm going to run all of these factories over here into some floating awesome sinks just to stress test the whole thing to make sure it can run at max efficiency and we don't have any problems. And with that, we're going to end it there. Next time, we're actually going to get started on, and we're going to finish, hopefully, the encased industrial beam part of the factory. In the interim, I might add a small coal plant with the remaining coal from over there. Just do the same thing we did upstairs, maybe about 1200 megawatts, just to kind of give us a little extra buffer. This is my tower for taking a picture. And that's about it. I hope everyone enjoyed it. And that is our finished steel pipe and beam factory. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Almost forgot a little night shot for you. Thanks for watching.